Robinson, what happens next now that this bill has been passed and the governor is going to sign it? What do you do next as a Democratic senator who opposed it?
Well, we've lost the legislative battle, but the war isn't over yet. There are several avenues in which we're pursuing. We feel very strongly that this bill was passed in violation of the laws of our state, open records laws, which require certain notices before legislative action is taken. Furthermore, we have recall elections out against 8 Republicans who voted for this bill. In a last analysis, the voters will have a chance to act on whether or not they want this type of representation.
Well, I understand there are recall efforts out there underway for both Republicans and Democrats. When you come back into session, I believe it's April, is that right? You're out of session now?
Well, we're supposed to be recessed under our recess resolutions.
Yeah.
However, the governor can call us back in special session anytime, and the special session that we were in has just been temporarily recessed.
Uh-huh. So when you come back, what happens?
Well, we'll go back to fight the biennial budget, which the governor has introduced. He has decided to gut public education, and he is furthermore taken the lifeblood out of aids to local units of government. The whole process that is subject to review, and we're going to be out there fighting to preserve the Wisconsin way.
Well, you've got a budget deficit you got to fix there. Where would you cut?
Well, the budget deficit is made up in large part by public employees acceding to the governor's request that they contribute more in their health care and in their various health care and pension programs. There are a number of other matters. The budget bill is introduced by the governor and will be reviewed by us. And it's not our responsibility to try to set up the budget right now. We are reacting to the governor's ideas, which we think are pretty bad.
You've made no bones about how bad you think those are, Senator Risser. In fact, in the past, you said Scott Walker has acted like a dictator. You know, his opponent, Tom Barrett, the former Milwaukee mayor who was on the Democratic ticket, came out just a day or so ago and said he knew that repealing the collective bargaining portion of this bill as a standalone process was something that you could do, and he would certainly favor it. Would you say Tom Barrett is also a dictator?
Well, I think he's a dictator in a way that he has not been listening to the public at all. He's been telling these Republican legislators what to do. They've been following him blindly, and in less than 2 months in office, he has done a lot to take a good share of the responsibility of legislature away from the legislature and put it in the executive branch. He's taken away all the rulemaking power. In this bill, he tries to take away the legislative oversight of Medicare, and it's a pattern which he's pursued and which makes, in my opinion, a dictatorial approach.